Dive in. Well, hello everyone. Michelle Molitor here at Nectar Consulting. I'm really delighted to be here and to be your guide today to share this new experience with you in a workshop. And yet, before we get started, I'm just curious, how many of you, like me, feel that life is too short to live from a place of fear? Anybody? Anybody on that same train with me? Yeah. Well, I get it. And that's why part of the reason why I do this work, and I'll share that story with you in a few minutes, but I'm also curious as to how many of you would agree that fear is a perspective. It's a perspective that we hold about ourselves, about the world, and it's these perspectives that can cause us great stress and anxiety, and they can cost us a lot too, in time
Absolutely.
and energy. And peace of mind, right? So think about where is fear costing you in your life? What is it costing in your life? And maybe just drop that in the chat. Where is fear holding you back? And if we can agree that fear is a perspective, then maybe we can also agree that there are some benefits to changing those perspectives, right? To perhaps find greater calm and clarity in our lives. Does that make sense? Yeah. Maybe even as we change those perspectives, we can create greater peace of mind, greater happiness, even greater success in our lives. Right? Wonderful. Well, I'm really delighted that you're here today. But before we dive in fully, I'd like you to just take a moment. To take a deep breath in, breathing in some gratitude for this new day, feeling your fingers and toes, just noticing any sensations you might be feeling in your body. As you tune into the wisdom of your body, not just your mind, right? And allowing yourself to just be here now. In this present moment. Why did I have you do that? Well, because today we're going to be having a conversation. And some of the conversation you're going to be having with yourself, right? So I want you to be here and be present with yourself and apparently the leaf blower outside. Hopefully, y'all can hear that. And I want you to have some honest conversations with yourself, right? This is a safe space, right? And you can share as much or as little as you choose. Because today we're going to be experiencing heart healing, right? In this workshop. And for many of you, this may include tapping into perhaps some childhood experiences or other wounds that you have lived through. And I want you to make sure that you're aware of what we're going to be discussing so you feel empowered to decide if this is the right place for you to be today, right? Before we begin. And I'll be sharing my details with you at the end of the workshop. So I'm here to be of support in whatever shape or form that needs to be for you, right? And when we get to the heart healing portion of the workshop in a little while, you're going to need to be in a space where you can relax and you hopefully won't be you'll be undisturbed and that you'll be able to say some things out loud to get the full benefit of the work that we're doing today, right? So if you need to move or you need to make yourself comfortable, go ahead and do that now before we get to that part of the workshop. Okay? Sound good? Fantastic. Welcome, Dennis. Nice to see you.
Thank
All right. So let me ask, who here has ever felt not enough? Has ever doubted yourself, doubted your capabilities, doubted if you belonged in the place or the space or around the people that you were with, right? Have you ever struggled to put yourself first instead of sacrificing yourself and putting everyone else's needs in front of yours just to make everyone else happy? right? Does this make sense, right? Or have you ever thought that you'd be able to love yourself more completely, to open up to receiving more, but yet that feels really hard to do because there's some part of you that says you're not worthy of love or deserving, or you're just not enough in some way, shape, or form? Well, if this resonates with you, then first and foremost, I want you to know you're not alone. This is very, very common. Not enoughness is something that everyone feels at some point in their lives. And it can dramatically hold you back if you let it get too deeply ingrained in your system. It can hold you back from living your most full life, your full potential, right? So why is this relevant? Why have you shown up here today? Well, I've learned an important lesson in my life that I think and hope that can make a real difference for you and yours too, on how to feel enough. And as you start to feel more enough, the impact that that can have and the ripple effect in all areas of your life. See, feeling enough is an inside job. It's not something that you can think your way through to, right? It's the inner work. And that's what we're going to be talking more about today. Because once you do the inner work, everything changes. So why is this so important to me? Well, why have I dedicated my life to working with and helping others to overcome their root causes of fear, their feelings of not enoughness? Well, it started back when I was a creative director in high tech, and I got bullied out of my corporate job. And it was so crushing to my confidence, to my value and worth. It created a massive case of corporate PTSD and imposter syndrome and left me wandering around like a deer in the headlights. And if that wasn't bad enough, the day that I got let go, I went home and I called my mom to tell her about my bad news. And she's like, "I'm sorry that you got laid off today. Our friend Al is dying." Just like that. She didn't miss a beat. And I was like, "What?" And it instantly changed my perspective. Like, so what? I lost my job today. My dear friend is dying. And so I got home and I thought, well, I got to figure out what I'm going to do next. And I happened to be leaving on vacation the next day. So I thought, self, Friday will be the first day of the rest of my life. I'm going to put my big girl panties on and figure out what I'm going to do and get on with doing it. And that morning, my dad called to tell me that my friend Al had died. And it really, really struck my heart because he didn't have to die. He just refused to take the cocktail of drugs that would have prolonged his life, because he was too afraid, too ashamed to live life for who he was. A wonderful, beautiful soul who happened to be a very closeted gay man in a small town. And it breaks my heart still to this day to know that he let himself die because he was too afraid to be who he is. So I dedicated my life and my work to doing this, to figuring out how to move past my own fear and to help others do the same. It's really become my mission in my work as a coach and a hypnotherapist. And I've spent the last 23 plus years researching and educating myself and going through umpteen million trainings and certifications just so I could feel enough to be the expert that I've become today. And so it's all about helping you all release these blocks, these thoughts of I'm not enoughness that are held deep in your subconscious mind, in your heart, and caught in your body. It's truly my passion and my joy to do this. I'm really delighted that you all are here today with me. So my promise here for you today is to do and to share with you the reasons why you don't feel enough. But more importantly, how do you change it so that you can receive more of what you want in your life? Whatever that more looks like, it looks different for everybody. So who here has seen The Wizard of Oz? Anybody? Yeah, one of my favorite movies, kind of a classic. Well, just like Dorothy, the key to finding your enoughness is within you. No, she clicks her ruby slippers together. There's no place like home. Home is in your heart. And if your heart has been wounded, you carry those wounds with you until you release them. So the tricky part is that oftentimes if we look outside of ourselves to make ourselves feel better by doing more, by giving more, achieving more, but it doesn't matter what you do or give or achieve externally if you haven't done the deeper healing on why you don't feel enough on the inside. Because when you don't feel enough, nothing will ever feel enough. There won't be enough money. There won't be enough time. There won't be enough love. Because enoughness is an inside job. So here's what I'll be sharing with you today. The three things, right? The reason why you don't feel enough and the hidden ways it might be showing up in your life, in your work, in your relationships. The stages of enoughness and the ingredients to feeling enough exactly as you are, perfectly blossom. And then how can you open up to receiving more in all areas of your life? And I'll be sharing with you also about how you can feel enough at this deeper level, right? And for those of you who are ready to go deeper on this journey of unlocking more of yourself, you're going to love this because I'm going to give you the keys on how to do that. And of course, at the end, I'll be taking you through a powerful taster, like a mini heart healing session to help you feel enough and to start receiving more. Because I really believe that the key to healing, the key to feeling enough, begins in your heart. So number one, the real reason you don't feel enough in hidden ways, it starts to show up for you. Well, it's the enoughness wound. This is a universal wound that everyone experiences in some way or another, regardless of how successful we may be in various parts of our lives. And when you have an enoughness wound, you don't feel enough, you don't believe you're enough, unconditionally. It's all conditional. If I do this, then I'll be enough. Or if I achieve this, then I'll be enough. And these blocks can then get in the way of having you receive the other things you want in your life. Your enoughness wound is the real reason you don't feel enough. And the unconditionally part, you're going to underscore that, right, is really important because most people think they only feel enough if they're doing enough or pleasing others enough or giving themselves to others enough. And they really struggle to feel enough just for who they are. I've had this myself. And when I finally realized that it had a name, I was like, oh, thank goodness. Now that I can see it, I can start to figure it out and heal it. That's the key. Now, we all have some version of this wound caused by different experiences or different relationships that have influenced it in our lives. It usually is formed within the first 6 to 7 years of our lives. And it holds us back in many, many ways. It's often developed as a protective mechanism or a way to keep you safe from painful emotions or experiences. You see, when we are children, we have very little control or choice over what our experience externally will be. We're dependent on the people around us for that most often times. And yet we're not emotionally mature enough to deal with strong emotions eternally. Our brains literally aren't fully formed until we're 25 years old. So your mind, your child mind, copes in the way that it best knows how. It forms beliefs that keep you safe from ever experiencing those strong emotions again. And we often don't know that it's impacting us until we learn about it, until we have that aha moment of, oh, that's what I'm feeling, which often comes years or even decades later. So it can actually be very deeply ingrained in your subconscious mind and heart. And we can't understand why we're holding ourselves back from having the things that we say we consciously want in our life, our relationships and our career, but yet we still keep holding ourselves back because there are those protective mechanisms and barriers and barricades that we've put up around our heart to keep us safe. And some people have this wound deeper than others. Research actually shows us that it impacts women more than men. And most often, this wound has been created unintentionally by someone in your life that you were close to, such as a parent who made you feel like you were only loved if you were good enough, or if you met certain conditions like good grades or good behavior, or comparing you to a sibling. Or someone placed unconditional or unrealistic expectations on you to be perfect or advanced for your age. It's also possible for this wound to have been created intentionally through experiences of abuse or trauma, which sadly are far more common than we might like to think. So what are some of the hidden ways it could be showing up for you? Right? There are so many ways, I can't cover them all today, but this is a good smattering of them that I thought I would share with you. And as I read these aloud, I just want you to write down any that resonate with you that you have now, or maybe they've resonated with you in the past, and share them in the comments if you feel happy to do so, right? Realizing again, know that you're not alone. It's really important. So here are some of the most common enoughness struggles. Struggling with confidence. Difficulty loving or liking yourself. Needing others to like and approve of you. Worrying what others think about you. Struggles with money or food or weight or relationships. Feeling stuck or settling in unhealthy or unhappy relationships. Allowing yourself to be treated unfairly or badly by family or friends, not setting clear boundaries. People-pleasing in relationships or work. Perfectionism or procrastination, one of my popular favorites. Overworking and not being paid for it. Putting up with negative behavior from colleagues or employers. Taking excessive courses or professional development just to feel enough. Having a lack of boundaries or always letting people overstep your boundaries. Feeling triggered by other people who are confident and successful. Overspending or dealing with different types of addictions like alcohol or food, exercise, work, even sex. Holding yourself back from what you really want to do and your true purpose. Or being very critical of yourself, comparing yourself to others. And again, my favorite, imposter syndrome, overgiving and overdoing. Do any of these resonate with y'all? Yeah. Just drop in the chat if you want some of the ones that have resonated most with you. So the second thing we're going to look at are the stages of enoughness. The essential ingredient to feeling enough exactly as you are. Now, there are three stages of enoughness. And these have been developed by my mentor, Natasha Bray, and inspired by the work of Dr. David Hamilton, who is a scientist and scientific researcher in the field of self-love. There's enoughness scarcity, enoughness bravery, and enoughness mastery. So I'll go through each of these in more detail. And as we go through them, just see what resonates most with you. And you might be in different stages of enoughness for different areas of your life as well, whether that's personally or professionally. Be surprised how these things creep in. So the first stage is enoughness scarcity. This is when deep down, whether consciously or subconsciously, you feel not enough most of the time. And feeling enough is actually a rare occurrence. And it shows up in all the hidden ways we just talked about. You struggle to love yourself. You struggle with confidence. You settle for things that you don't want, bad jobs, bad relationships. You feel undeserving of good things. You're self-critical. You compare yourself to others, and you struggle with money, with your weight, with your well-being. The second stage is enoughness bravery. This is where you start to recognize that something is not right or not okay about how things are currently going in your life. And you've become brave enough to question the things you have settled for. You question the way you're treated by others or the way you're treating yourself. Or there's circumstances that you have found yourself in. You're brave enough to decide no more. You've had enough and you're ready to choose something different for yourself. And you actually take steps in the direction of finding a solution, whether that's changing your career or ending a relationship that isn't working or learning to invest in yourself. The most important thing about this stage is that you're ready to take action, to change things, to get into action, to create a better way of moving through the world. The third stage is enoughness mastery. And this is where you finally begin to feel enough on so many levels. You start to feel enough as you are, for who you are, not just for what you do or what you give to others. You start to feel greater inner peace, a sense of love and acceptance for yourself that maybe has been missing. And it allows you to put yourself first, to set strong boundaries, and to let go of the people-pleasing that you've been prisoner to. You start to radiate confidence and feel safe for being all of who you are authentically. This is where your energy shifts and where the world around you shifts to meet you where you are, perfectly imperfect, just as you are. And your thoughts and your thoughts impact your feelings and your behaviors. So when you believe you are enough, you start to show up as if you are enough. And then you begin to magnetize to you the perfect people, opportunities, and circumstances in your life that reinforce this. It's a really exciting thing to experience. So you start to create a new reality in your internal world. And then that starts to create a new reality on your external world as well. So where are you now? And where do you want to be? Drop the number in the chat of which enoughness wound resonates most with you, if you feel comfortable to do so. This is a safe place for everyone here today. You just get to notice, am I feeling not enough? I've had enough, or I am enough, right? Yeah, we've got some twos. It's awesome. So how do we start to create the shift? You're probably wondering, right? The place where we start to feel enough just as we are and just as we aren't. Well, the essential ingredient to feeling enough is healing your heart. Not enoughness is a wound of the heart. It allows us to bypass the slow surface mind healing that happens and go straight to the heart of the issue for fast and deep results. It's not enough to try to think your way to feeling enough. You have to really feel it in your heart. And the only way to do this is to find and release yourself from the true root causes of the wounds that created the "I don't feel enough" in the first place, right? This is not found in the mind alone. It's really, you got to go into the feeling places And you can do that with far more ease than you might imagine. And the key to this is, as you get at the root causes of that and you release that not enoughness wound, you also release it from your body, from your nervous system. So you let go of the triggers that once kept you caught in those negative thought loops of I'm not enough. So let me give you a random example. A stranger on the street walks up to you and tells you, you're useless and stupid. Or your mother tells you you're useless and stupid. Which of these do you think will affect your heart more? The person you have the closest relationship with, or the random human being on the street? You might feel shocked or hurt by some random stranger coming and tell you that. But when your mother says it to you, you think, oh my gosh, my mother thinks that about me. It must be true. Especially when we're just little kids, we don't know any better. We're just taking in data from our environment. And so that deep enoughness wound gets created, gets sparked in that moment, and we make a decision about ourselves. I'm not enough. And that wound on your heart can last a lifetime if it's never addressed. So we need to reveal and heal the root cause that caused that not enoughness wound in the first place. This is what heart healing does. It's this revolutionary therapy that I've been trained in by my mentor, Natasha Bray. She's won many awards for this work and has been approved by our certification organizations in different countries in the world. And it's really, really amazing. It's even going to be featured in a new upcoming film with Dr. Joe Vitale coming up later this year. And the thing is when you realize you have these wounds, then you realize you can start to heal these wounds. Did you know that the heart has an energetic frequency 5,000 times stronger than that of the mind? And that research also shows us the mind actually responds to the heart, not the other way around. So doesn't it make sense to heal your heart, to create bigger transformation, faster transformation than you would by just healing your mind? Yeah, I thought so. This is why mindset work alone may not have worked for you in the past, because you've been trying to shift it from a mindset perspective only. So we've all had experiences that have impacted our heart, whether it's a loss or a trauma or feeling rejected or betrayed. Perhaps you felt judged, not accepted, abandoned, or just not enough in some way, shape, or form. We learn instinctively, especially as children, to put up walls around our hearts to stop us from ever feeling that intense pain again. But in doing so, we create those blocks, those barriers to connection with other people, to feeling loved, to keeping us from the things we truly desire in life, keeping us from the money, the love, the success, the happiness, the well-being that we truly want, that sometimes feels just out of reach. And the curious thing is, most therapies focus on addressing the mind. They don't focus on getting at the root causes of the experience. That's why heart healing is so powerful, because it goes really deep to break down those walls that you've put up around your heart by unveiling the cycles of wounding passed down intentionally or unintentionally through family dynamics. This powerful approach unveils hidden blocks that the mind-based techniques alone don't uncover, and rapidly removes them. And the people who have experienced it say, gosh, it just feels like so much freedom that I've achieved now, giving you so much more joy, abundance, peace of mind. I personally have experienced it, and I've witnessed it with the hundreds, thousands of people that I've worked with. And when you can create that alignment between your head and your heart and your spirit, that's when you start feeling really, truly aligned and working and living on purpose. When you work with the heart, it influences your heart, your mind, and your spirit. And we can psychologically, emotionally, and energetically heal those wounds passed down through generations and break the cycle for ourselves and for future generations. It's really powerful, and it's actually the most powerful modality that I've ever experienced, and I'm a learning junkie. I've tried them all, right? So let me tell you about Janae. Janae came to me with severe anxiety, so much so that it was preventing her from leaving her house. And she was just distraught because it kept getting worse. And the anxiety triggered a severe case of IBS, inflammatory bowel syndrome. And this had been going on for 15 years. And through our work together, when we got at the root cause of the beliefs that she was carrying, caused by her dad when she was in high school, who was her basketball coach, he literally would tell her, "You played by like crap." And she became an excessive people pleaser just to win his love and approval. When she discovered that and she turned it off, her IBS went away, literally. So it's really powerful when you connect those dots and heal those internal wounds. So how can you start to open up to receiving more? Well, it's really about removing those barriers as you heal your heart and as you expand your capacity to receive. You see, we all have an energetic mechanism that determines how much we allow ourselves to receive, right? How much love can we receive? How much money can we receive? How much goodness? How much fun? How much joy? Literally anything. We have like an energetic ceiling. And if you think at some part of your system, "Oh, I'm not deserving of that. I'm not worthy. I'm not enough," you will push it away. This concept first was published by psychologist Gay Hendricks, and our capacity to receive is impacted by our thoughts and our feelings about ourselves. So how enough we feel affects our capacity to receive. So if we feel not enough, if we believe we're not enough, we're not allowing ourselves to receive more of the things that we want, right? And then this can snowball into leading to self-sabotaging behaviors, blocking ourselves further from receiving the good things. So for example, maybe if you feel not enough in partnership, you might create an argument with your partner when things are really going well. Or maybe you're working on losing some weight and you've lost a couple of pounds, but then you self-sabotage by going on a food binge again. Or perhaps you're procrastinating on a project, only amplifying your stress and your negative thought loops, right? So the key to expanding your capacity is really doing this internal work, because your heart has such a powerful energetic influence on your internal world, thus impacting your external world as well. So how does it work, right? Well, there are three parts to heart healing. There's the heart inquiry, right? And this is how we step into a deeper reflective state. It's an alpha brainwave state that allows us to get at the root causes of the wound. Then there's the second step, heart healing. And this is a unique and powerful combination of tried and tested therapeutic processes to heal and transform the root cause of your relationship with yourself, to break down those energetic walls and barriers around your heart and to reconnect you with the truth of yourself. And then the third step is heart imprinting. This is where, with repetition, we embed new thoughts and feelings, behaviors on your mind and heart while putting a stop to unconscious self-sabotaging behaviors. Because this is a very relaxing recording that you listen to at night as you drift off to sleep. And the repetition of listening to that over and over and over again is literally what builds new neural pathways in your brain, empowering you to stand up a little taller, to feel more confident every day that you listen to it. Sounds kind of magical, right? Well, it's all grounded in cutting edge science and energetics and spirituality. And through this work, I actually combine my 20 plus years of coaching mastery, somatic therapy, neuro-linguistic programming, Reiki, and so much more to create really astounding results for my clients. See, heart healing is a very rapid and powerful therapeutic technique, which dramatically expands your heart in as little as 90 minutes. Not 90 days, not 9 months, not 9 years. The power of this work is astounding. I like to think of it as a way to rapidly rewire your mind, heart, and spirit. And the beauty of this work is that it is so new. It is cutting edge. As I mentioned earlier, it's been recognized and accredited by the United Kingdom Association of Coaches, Counselors, Psychotherapists, and Hypnotherapists, and is described by professionals with decades of experience as the missing link to anything that they have ever been trained in before. So I'm excited to share that I'm one of less than 150 practitioners worldwide who do this work. So I'm really thrilled to share it with you today. And this is just some of the comments that folks have shared about their heart healing experiences. Feeling amazing after a session, the most profound healing modality I've had the pleasure and honor of experiencing. I find myself just doing things without any hesitation or second guessing myself. Getting out from behind fear and confidence took courage. Michelle is masterful at her craft. It has been life-changing. So start to think about what's the experience you want to have, right? But don't worry. These folks, they too were where you are now, feeling not enough and doubting themselves and sacrificing themselves. They too wanted to open up to receiving more love, more happiness, more success in their lives. So imagine what's possible. What would it feel like to feel enough? Right? And how would that impact your life in different ways? What if you imagine if you were able to let go of the fear, the limiting beliefs that your negative mind is trying to convince you of, and you release it from your nervous system? Let's sit with that for just a minute. Like, what would your life really look like and feel like? You're able to release the pain, the trepidation, the preconceived notions about how your life is supposed to look and feel, and actually step into feeling it simply by changing your perspective, by healing your heart, so you can have more of what you do want in life and less of what you don't want. So drop in the chat for me, what's one thing that you want to transform in your life? What's the thing you want more of in your life if you're able to heal this not enoughness wound? Any thoughts? All right. So before we dive in, freedom, thank you. Thank you for sharing that. To be true to myself. Yes, absolutely. So before we drop into the heart healing taster session, I'd love to tell you about a special offer that I have to work with me right now. that goes deep into healing your enoughness wounds and expanding your capacity to receive more joy, more freedom, to be more authentic with yourself in your life, and the ripple effect that that can create. So I'm happy to say that I have three different ways to work with me currently, and each has a special offer for you today. So number one, if you want to combat your enoughness scarcity, I recommend my How to Become Unshakable membership. This is an online course to shake your not enoughness and your self-doubt, and you go at your own pace. It includes monthly group coaching and access to my amazing expert masterclass library to support you and your growth exactly where you are. You can save 50% today with the special offer. Now, if you want to, number two, you want to step into enoughness bravery, I have a 4-month program called Reclaiming Your True Self. Sorry, gentlemen, this is only for the ladies. And it includes individual and collective heart healing and coaching. Now, most women choose this one to apply for because there's only limited spaces. There are actually only 6 spaces in a cohort. And there's a 25% savings on the Reclaiming Your True Self program today. The next group starts on April 10th. And for those of you who want to achieve enoughness mastery, well, then my 1-to-1 custom breakthrough programs are just right for you. They include customized individual heart healing and coaching and unlimited access to me and to my library of resources and tools to expand your success and so much more. And there's a 15% savings on this mastery program. So now, most people who are where you are, text me right now to book their 1-to-1 clarity call. It's free, it's complimentary, and it's confidential, right? To see what breakthrough program is actually right for you, to meet you where you are on your journey, to get you from where you are to where you want to be. So I'm going to drop my cell phone number right here in the chat message for you. You can text me there, or if you want to just go straight to my calendar, you can go and book that right here and drop that in the chat as well. But just text me. We'll find a time to talk and I can listen and hear where you're at and what you're dealing with on how this not enoughness wound is impacting your life in different ways, shapes, and forms. Now, if you're prepared to give this a try, then I'm certain that you will see results in just a few weeks. And spaces are limited. So be sure to text me or book your time and we can talk further and see what's going to be right for you. Oh, and these discounts, they're only available for the next 48 hours. So just book a time with me to apply to what program might be right for you and you'll receive the discounts available today. Okay? So let's get ready to drop in to our heart healing session. But first, I have to cover the legal stuff. This workshop includes a taster heart healing session, and it involves being put into a deeply relaxed hypnotic state. So if you have epilepsy or a psychotic illness, you should not go into hypnosis. You continue with this webinar, you're accepting full responsibility for taking part in the hypnosis and agreeing that Michelle Molitor holds no liability for any potential outcomes. Okay, legal stuff done. All right. So I want you to get comfortable, sit back, relax. You can leave your camera on. You can turn it off. It's totally up to you. And know that this is a taster session. This is not a full-blown heart healing session, right? I've been trained in using these techniques and the full one-to-ones are very customized and tailored to you and your challenges. But even this taster session will be really powerful for you. I know you're going to love it. And it's going to help you find some root causes of some things. So go ahead and make yourself comfortable. Taking a deep breath in, allowing yourself to rest into the place that you are. And just remember that you are completely safe here today as we go on this journey of healing your heart. So now I want you to open your eyes and look up as high as you possibly can. Imagine that you're looking into your center of your forehead, looking up at your eyebrows as you take a deep breath in and out. Taking another deep breath in and out. And each time you blink, that is relaxation coming upon you. And on the third inhale, keeping your eyelids right up, all the way up, as you close your eyelids right down, all the way down. And as your eyelids shut down, you can feel the muscles and nerves in and around your eyes becoming heavy, dreamy, drowsy. And your eyelids feel so heavy now, as if they've been glued shut, sealed shut, locked together. You can feel a wave of calm and relaxation washing over you now as you let your eyes relax, as that relaxation spreads all throughout your whole body. And now you can see, feel, sense yourself standing at the top of the most beautiful golden staircase in your mind's eye. The staircase only has 10 steps. And you see yourself looking down those 10 steps now. And you feel safe. You feel supported, ready to begin this healing journey today. You look down those beautiful 10 golden steps now. And as I count backwards, you're going to see yourself, feel yourself walking down each and every golden step. You feel safe. You feel calm. You feel relaxed as you see yourself walking down, drifting down, getting closer and closer. Moving down that beautiful golden staircase, you're moving on to golden step 10 and 9 now. As each muscle, every nerve turns loose, lets loose, and you go deeper, you're moving on to golden step 8 and 7. As you go deeper and deeper, as every muscle, every nerve in your body deeply relaxes, feeling a wave of peace and calm moving through you. You're taking golden step 6 and 5 as you drift deeper and deeper. As you gently, calmly, easily move on over to a deep and deeper level. You're taking golden step 4 as you drift deeper and further into this wonderful, relaxed state of being. You're taking golden step 3 as you feel your body, your mind drifting deeper, relaxing deeper, going deeper, more and more. Taking golden step 2 as you easily and calmly drift, float, glide all the way down to an even deeper level than you've ever felt before. Drifting all the way down, taking golden step 1 as you just sleep deeply now, drift deeply, go deeply. And every time I say the words drift deeper, you're going deeper and deeper. As you drop your shoulders, relax your jaw, unclench your hands now as you simply let go. As you feel that wave of relaxation from your head all the way down to your toes, feeling just so relaxed now, feeling safe, feeling comfortable, feeling calm. And as you drift deeper and deeper now, you find you're listening with your subconscious mind. As your conscious mind just drifts further and further away. And as you drift further away, you're going deeper into a level where you are responsible for healing your heart. So imagining now there at the bottom of that beautiful golden staircase is an amazing golden doorway. And this doorway is opening up, inviting you in, taking you on a journey within yourself, within your body, until you find yourself standing in front of your beautiful beating heart, the portal to your soul. You feel so small next to it. You can see it. You can feel it. You can hear it calmly beating as you notice your heart is surrounded by a thick stone wall. You walk all around trying to find a way in. You can't. So you grab a hold of that wall and you pull yourself up and over easily to access your own beautiful beating heart. The sound of your beating heart gets louder now as you get closer and closer to it. And there you notice a doorway opening up into your heart. It opens up and you peer inside. And there inside you see a beautiful glowing fire. This is your heart light. This is the safe space within your heart where all truth is revealed. And as you walk inside and you look around, you see to your left a younger version of you, a little person who's crying, who is sobbing, who feels not enough in some way. And you walk over to them, you bend down on one knee, taking them by the hand, and they look at you, and you look at them, and they know that you are them all grown up, and you know that they are you as a little child. And they feel safe. They trust you. They open up to you. How old are they? What do they say? And as you gently take them by the hand, you ask this younger version of yourself, why do you feel not enough? And they open up to you and tell you about a time when someone they love hurt them, upset them, making them feel not enough. This person that comes to mind, this is the root cause of your not enoughness wound. And it's time for us to heal this wound. So as you look at that younger version of yourself, you ask them, who is the person you love that made you feel this way? And they point to the other side of the fire. And there on the other side of the fire is the person who hurt you, sitting in a chair. It might be a parent, might be a family member, might be a friend. Who is it that comes to mind? Who do you see sitting in that chair? It's important to know that your younger self is safe here. You are protecting them. So together you walk towards the person sitting in their chair, knowing that you are safe and supported as you do. And so I want you to notice now the pain, the not enoughness wounds, the cords of negative energy that are connecting your body to the body of the person who has hurt you. These are the pain cords that have connected you to this not enoughness wound all of this time. What do these cords look like? Do they have a color or a texture? How many can you see, sense, feel? Where on your body are they connected to? So you can see, feel, sense these negative energy cords, these wounds that have connected you to this other person all this time. And yet now, if it's right for you, I want you to also see the love cords coming from your body attaching to that person. This is the love that is felt between the two of you, if it's appropriate. And you get to notice, what do these love cords look like? Do they have a color, a texture? How many of these love cords are there? And where are they coming from out of your body and into theirs? Now, in just a moment, you're going to pull out all of the negative pain cords. All of the negative pain cords that have connected you to this wound and to this person all of this time. And as you pull them all out by the root, you find they come out easily, leaving only the love cords behind. And as you remove them completely by the root, in just a moment, you're going to pull them all out. And I want you to say out loud, I'm letting go of the pain and leaving only love. So take a hold of those negative pain cords, and I want you to give them all a good tug, pulling them all out, all the way out by the root, and say out loud, I'm letting go of the pain and leaving only love. And as you drop those negative pain cords to the floor, I want you to say out loud, I'm taking my power back now. And there's this big pile of negative pain cords there on the floor. So you and your younger self, you pick up that pile of negative pain cords and you throw them into the fire. They are burning up. They are going, gone. They cannot, they will not, they do not impact your heart ever, ever again. You have let them go. They are a thing of the past. They are disappearing, dissolving away like smoke. And now all of those pain cords are gone and you feel so warm, tingly feeling inside. You feel your heart, your soul, your energy expanding out in all directions. You feel so light, so free, so joyful from the inside out. And you can look and see that those love cords that are still there, when they start to double and triple in size, they're getting thicker and stronger, radiating this beautiful light. And you feel a deep sense of peace and acceptance for the past and towards this person for the wound that they caused you. But you're also feeling a deeper sense of love and acceptance for yourself too, as you realize it wasn't your fault. And that you are enough. You always have been enough. So you and your younger self now come together in a beautiful, warm, loving embrace. And a bright white light of love surrounds you both. This bright white love light is filled with particles of peace and love. And these particles of peace and love, they flood throughout your whole body, filling you up from the inside out with pure peace and love and joy. It feels so incredible, like nothing you've ever experienced before. It rushes into all those wounded places and spaces where those pain cords were attached, repairing them cell by cell with particles of love and peace. And that bright white light of love picks up anything that doesn't belong in your body anymore. All the pain, all the sadness, all the beliefs that are stopping you from truly, deeply loving and accepting yourself. That bright white light of love heals all of that. Now, as that light starts to fade away, taking all remnants of any bad stuff with it, it's taking away that person who once hurt you, leaving only deep love and peace in its place. So now you sit down on that empty chair and you look around the heart chamber, and it's just you and that younger version of you left now. They're so happy. They come running over to you, laughing and smiling, giving you the hugest hug. They feel so happy, so free, because you finally gave them a voice. You had the power to set them free. And you wrap your arms around them now, look them deep into the eyes, and give them all the love they always needed and deserved. As you look them sweetly in the face, I want you to say out loud to them, "I love you unconditionally. You are so important to me. I'm sorry for what you went through. It wasn't your fault. You are safe now. I will protect you. You will never be alone. I'm always here for you. You are loved more than you know. You are absolutely, unconditionally, more than enough. We are healed now." And so that younger version of you looks up at you and nods their head to say, "Okay, I'm ready now." And their little body begins to integrate with your body. Your heart, your minds come together, integrating together, becoming one whole heart. And as your hearts become one, it sends an explosion of love and enoughness all throughout your body that breaks down those walls of stone, steel, and glass that once were surrounding your heart. You're letting go of anything now that has been stopping you from loving yourself. Anything that was stopping you from believing that you are enough has been completely removed, erased, eradicated from your mind, heart, and spirit. Your heart is whole. Your heart is free. And your heart is wide open to receiving all of its desires now, and it feels so incredible. And as you look around the heart chamber one more time, you see someone come out of the shadows. It looks a lot like you, but they're different. This is your higher self, your older, wiser self. They wanted to come and tell you how amazing you are, how proud they are of you for doing this deeper work today, to remind you that you are always safe and supported, telling you how excited they are because they've been waiting for this moment for so long. This moment when you finally freed yourself and your heart from the pain and allowed them in. Your higher self takes you by your hands because they have some really important guidance they want you to know right now. So what is it that they're telling you? Say this guidance out loud or to yourself now. Remembering that this guidance will easily come back to you whenever you need it to, as you come back to full awareness. So you give your higher self a hug, and the two of you walk out of that chamber, and you notice that the heart, that the wall around your heart is no more. It has been eradicated, and you feel so light, so free. And you truly see and understand now that you are not your younger self. Nothing you went through was your fault, and you have always been more than enough. And you love, trust, and accept yourself deeply and unconditionally now. So you give your higher self one more hug, and they disappear. And you see that golden door ahead, and you're ready to come back through it now, coming back to your body, feeling whole, feeling transformed, feeling complete. So you're now drifting to a level where your heart, mind, and soul are ready for deep and profound healing. Every part of you is ready to let go of the past, to let in peace, safety, and love. You're ready to heal all that has been holding you back from being absolutely enough and to step fully into all that you have been meant to be and become. You have the power to choose, and you are choosing to deeply and completely love, trust, and believe in yourself from this moment forward. You know you are absolutely lovable unconditionally, that you are more than enough, and you are safe to step into your power now. Whatever you've been through in the past, your heart is more than capable of growing back stronger, more loving than ever before. You were created for a reason. The universe loves you. It's given you every single experience in your life to shape you into the amazing person here today. And you realize nothing you ever went through was your fault, and you are choosing to take your power back now. You're a wonderful person. You deserve good things, and it's safe for you to be successful. Safe for you to make mistakes. Safe for you to achieve your dreams. And from now on, you are someone who unconditionally loves, trusts, and believes in themselves. You know you are worthy and deserving of extraordinary love, success, abundance. And because you want to love yourself and your life, you are choosing to completely let go, letting go of anything that has once been stopping you from having everything you want in your life, achieving all your dreams. It is all just a thing of the past, the pain. It has all just been let go now of. You are free. You're healed now, and you are taking your power back as the incredible, confident, successful person that you are. And as you realize it's safe for you to be powerful, safe for you to be you, safe for you to feel enough on every level, you step fully into your authentic self. You recognize that you are special, you have purpose, and you are stepping into your purpose. And that confidence, that enoughness, it radiates out off of you in all directions, attracting to you all the perfect people, opportunities, and circumstances to create your life in ways you hadn't yet even imagined. Because now is your time. and you accept the past, and you have chosen to let go of the past now, and you feel so free, free to be even more successful, more confident, more happy, just as you have always been destined to be. And now that you believe in yourself, you know on a deep level, you are enough. You're opening up to all forms of abundance in your life. More love, more money, more success, better health, incredible happiness. Right now, you're choosing to let go of anything and everything that has been affecting your ability to love, trust, and believe in yourself. And you're letting yourself be flooded with peace and love. From now on, you love, trust, and believe in yourself in a new way, in a deeper way than you ever have before. And this deep sense of wholeness inside you, you feel it. You feel so peaceful, so calm, so content with yourself, with the past, and with the world. Your heart is now free to unconditionally love and accept yourself. You're free to unconditionally love, trust, and believe in yourself now because your heart is open. You've opened the floodgates to receiving all of your heart's desires with ease, grace, and flow. And good things are flowing towards you daily now as you are ready to receive. And your whole life is changing for the better in the most magical and wonderful ways. And in just a moment, I will bring you back to your full awareness. You will instantly feel more confident and more enough as you awaken, as you come back to awareness. You have a deep desire to be more loving and accepting toward yourself. You believe you are enough. You feel you are enough. And you act like a person who knows they are enough. So feeling whole, feeling transformed, feeling complete. On the count of three, one, two, three. You can gently start to open your eyes now, taking a deep breath in, wiggling your fingers, wiggling your toes, feeling yourself coming back to full awareness. Knowing that the universe is always here for you, protecting you, supporting you, guiding you right now. So come back, turn your cameras back on, and let me know how that was for you. Unmute yourself. Just feel free to share. Raul, how was that for you?
That was interesting. I have to admit, I was nodding off a little bit.
I like to call that a hypno nap. It's very relaxing. You're not really asleep, but your mind is hearing everything that I'm saying. Well done. You passed. Not that there was a pass fail. Indra, how about for you?
It was very relaxing. I was like super relaxed, but I had like I couldn't like visualize anything. No stairs, no nothing. It was just blank. But it was nice listening to your voice. Relaxing.
Okay, great. Well, you know, that's fine. Everybody does it differently. Some people are more visual. Some people are more auditory. Some people are more kinesthetic. Right.
I was like almost analyzing like during like tried to meditate, right? So kind of let all the sounds come and but don't pay attention to anything. Sort of.
Good. Well done. Anyone else care to share? No? Okay. Well, for some of you, it may bubble up to the surface, all different thoughts or emotions. And sometimes it happens instantly. Sometimes it happens over time. So just start to notice what's bubbling up for you over the coming days. Because as you do, it's time. It's time to leave your past in your history book. All the drama, all the trauma, just leave it. Put it down like an old suitcase. You no longer need it. Through this work, you can discover how to step joyfully into your future as your most authentic you yet. To unlock your full confidence and success as you become absolutely enough. Now, as I see it, you have three options. First, you could keep doing what you're doing, getting what you're getting, maybe feeling dissatisfied or disconnected or even anxious. Second, you can read another book, maybe listen to another podcast and try and fix yourself. This is how I used to operate, right? Or third, you can just give this a try, either in a group setting or working one-to-one with me to share, to create, to start to create a powerful, long-lasting change in your life, in your career, in your mind, heart, and spirit. As you free yourself from the past and the hurts and the fear that have been holding you back from having a life filled with greater satisfaction, with greater joy, with greater freedom, right? So of those three options, what's going to be easiest for you? Let's connect and see what path of transformation will work best for you, where you are, and the challenges you're ready to leave behind in the rearview mirror once and for all. So the next step is really simple. You can either point your camera at the QR code and book directly on my schedule there, or you can text me at my cell phone number right there, or I'm gonna put this over here into the chat. There we go. Or there's a link to my discovery session. It's a free, complimentary, and confidential call that we can have together to see what's going to be right for you and how I might be of support to meet you where you are and get you where you want to be faster than you would on your own. Because as we started this conversation with, life is too short to live from a place of fear. Thank you for joining me here today, my friends. It's been really delight to share this experience with you. I hope it's been thought-provoking for you and relaxing. And I look forward to answering any questions now that you have and being of service in any way that I can. So any questions?
No.
No? Fantastic. All right. Well, thank you all so very much. I hope you have a blessed day and this refreshes you as you move into the rest of your day, your evening, depending where you are in the world. And if you have any questions, feel free to text me or email me, reach out, and I'll be happy to answer them as best I can. All right.
Thank you.
All right, everyone. Take care. Blessings.
Bye. Bye. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.